Hello everyone and welcome back to another episode of Animating Simple Shapes in PowerPoint Tutorial. In this tutorial, I will teach you to create an illusionary animated background using triangle shapes. This animation is inspired by the work of So Many Questions at Imgur.com. So, let's begin by opening a new presentation in PowerPoint and then changing the layout to blank from the Home tab. Change the slide background color by right-clicking on an empty area of the slide, and then choose Format Background. We are going to use a black color. From the Insert tab, click the Shapes drop-down menu and then draw a triangle shape. You can reduce the size of an object simultaneously from all the sides by holding the Ctrl, Shift, and Alt keys. We need a very small size triangle. Now, change the fill color to white and remove the outline color from the Shape Format tab. Make a duplicate of this triangle by holding the Ctrl and Shift keys while dragging and dropping them to the right side. That is the easiest way of making a duplicate of an object at the desired position, and the red guides help you to identify the position. As we need around 30 triangles in a row, so now you can use the F4 key to repeat the last command and to make further copies of the triangle while having the same distance between them. Now we need to make more rows of the triangles to fill up the height of the slide. So, select all the triangles by pressing the Ctrl plus a key, and then drag and drop to the bottom while holding the Ctrl key, to create a second row of the triangles. Adjust the position of the second row by moving all the triangles to one step to the left or right side. As we need to fill the slide with so many rows of triangles, so now you can select both rows and then drag and drop to the bottom while holding the Ctrl key. Then start pressing the F4 key to make further copies. Once you filled the entire slide with the triangles, it will be a good idea to select all the shapes and use the Merge Shapes Combine command from the Shape Format tab to make them a single shape. If you don't have Merge Shapes, then you can also use the Group command. I have noticed this several times that when you use so many shapes on a single slide, then it slows down the performance of PowerPoint. So, converting all the shapes into a single shape using the Combine command will be better for a smooth performance. You can open the Selection pane to see the difference between the Combine and Group commands. Once you have a complete triangle shape ready, you can align it to the center and middle of the slide from the Shape Format tab. Now make a duplicate of this shape and place it exactly on top of the previous one. From the Animations tab, click the Add Animation drop-down menu, and then apply the Spin Emphasis effect. Open the Animation pane and double-click the effect to open the Effect Options window. Here from the Timings tab, set to start with previous with a time duration of 10 seconds, and repeat until the end of the slide. See the slideshow, and there you have an illusionary animated background ready to use for your other projects. If you want, then you can do a few more experiments to get different results. Like, applying a different fill color and outline color to the top shape will give you a different effect. You can also apply smooth start and smooth end with auto reverse from the effect options, and then you will see a completely different version of the animation. So, I hope you will find this tutorial informative and interesting. Let me know your feedback by liking, sharing, and commenting on this video. Make sure to subscribe to our channel for more upcoming tutorial videos. Thanks a lot for watching the video, and we will meet in our next video. Bye and take care.